Morning, everybody. Welcome to Kieran Rogers University. I am Ed Cruz, and today we're going to focus on something that's very confusing in the world of Wing Chun, and that's actually what you practice and what you actually do in a real combat situation. I think there's a great, great misunderstanding on how the things we do in practice are applied actually on the street, and it's not anyone's fault because it's very confusing. One of the things of Wing Chun is it can be confusing. It's left to a lot of interpretation if you don't really have a good teacher to explain certain things. And fortunately, I was in the situation where, you know, my teacher had a lot of experience and he really knew his stuff. So first, let's talk about forms first, okay? That's something that everyone's pretty familiar with. You have basically only six forms in Wing Chun. You have basically Silm Tao Chum QBG, three hand forms, and you have dummy and then sword and pole. So take, for instance, you have Silm Tao. People have Silm Tao, you know the form and so forth, and you practice this. But yet exactly what you're practicing and why you're practicing it, people look at the motion in Silm Tao. Let's say, for example, right? Second section, when you do like this motion, this Gum Tao motion, you see that and you're like, okay, how am I applying this? Am I constantly going down to apply this? If someone's going to my feet, I gum somebody down. But you have to understand, if you do a drill, ask yourself what exactly is the skill that you're getting, okay? Because I think that if you constantly ask yourself that, you'll understand exactly why you're doing it. Because most of the time people think, I do a drill, this is how I'm gonna apply it. I need this situation to come about. But that's not the case. Like with the Gum Tao, I'm not always going like this to deal with anybody. There's so many ways that I can apply the Gum Tao, but that's the initial move that teaches me the individual technique that I want to develop. Going along with the shifting, right? We see people shifting when we shift, right? We see footwork like this, right? You see like three angle stepping like this. And then next thing you know, in a fight situation, when someone tries to apply the Wing Chun, you see somebody actually moving like this. That's not exactly the case. You ever see the move three angle step? Three angle step looks like this. You step and then you have a circle, right? The actual reason for that footwork is actually what? To develop a particular skill. And that skill is taking a longer step. Now, if I were to take, for example, a longer step, right? You see me lose my center of gravity and end up being longer. But if I circle my motion, I still maintain my center of gravity and take a bigger step. That skill is what you're developing. And once you know how to take a bigger skill and maintain your center of gravity, that's what you develop. But you're not actually applying this anymore in actual real fight situation. So what you do in class and how you apply it are two totally different things. Okay, you see when we chi sao with each other, right? And then in the fight situation, you're like, okay, I'm gonna try to apply the chi sao that way. That's not the purpose of chi sao, right? If you try to apply that, ask yourself once again, what is the skill I'm trying to develop from chi sao? And chi sao is not being like this, right? I'm not trying to touch the person and so forth. In a fight situation, you are trying to win, you are trying to hit. And it never, ever should look exactly what you see in school. And practice in school as opposed to what you actually apply on the actual street itself. You see the guard hand, right? This is the Wing Chun guard hand in Wing Chun. If you see your guard hand come out in the fight situation, you're toast. You never show the guard hand, ever, ever. But again, what am I developing when I have the guard hand like this? If I actually apply Wing Chun in a fight situation, I won't go, here's my guard hand and then chain punch. But in a real situation, if I want to punch, boom, I'm punching, right? Now when I punch, right, it just comes out naturally. But look, for a split second, right, you see a triangle form. There's a triangle from that situation and then I launch it. But yet, at the same time, like I said, what is the skill that you want to develop, right? Or you're trying to develop when you practice it. So when you see something in class and you see something on the street, don't mix the two together. That's not how it works. If you look robotic, like you are in class, and there's nothing wrong with looking robotic in the class because that's how you train in the beginning until you look actually natural, that's fine. That's part of the training process. But in the actual street, you can't look like that. And when we talk about the footwork originally, we're talking footwork like this and so forth. You're not standing in place in Wing Chun. If I'm standing and applying Wing Chun, I'm standing like this, right? The purpose of the Yi Chi Kei Yun Ma is to control your center of gravity. It has nothing to do like standing like this or fighting like this, right? My skill is here. I can control my center of gravity. If the force comes in, I don't topple over. I don't lean over to the side. No matter what, I'm like a ping pong ball. You can hit me from side to side. I'll still stay up straight, totally. Now, am I standing straight like this? No, I can actually move around with my center of gravity. I have free freedom of motion. So there's no limitation to what I can do. Because once again, what is the individual skill? Okay? So just keep that in mind. I know that's confusing. That's no fault of your own. It's a lot of Wing Chun people fall into that trap of thinking, okay, this is how I do it. This is how I should apply it. But just remember the rule of thumbs. What is the skill I'm trying to develop? Not this is the drill and this is how I should apply it. Okay? Anyway, if you love the channel, I know a lot of people enjoyed the Bruce Lee stuff last week. I'll try to do more of that. If you love the channel, thank you so much. Please subscribe, share, comment, and so forth. And once again, let's see. More stuff coming in. I know I said I was going to have stuff on Friday, but the Zoom classes are taking a lot of time up. So if you can, try to join us for Zoom classes on Karen Rice Facebook University. Join us for that, and the classes are free. We're actually finishing the tail end of the sword forms. And okay, hopefully you enjoy.